Hello everyone, I'm Sini, one of the team members of Team 39 participating in the Summer Nusantara Project 2021. We are honored to have this opportunity to be a part of the project. In this presentation, we would like to present the problems in Singapore Airlines Limited due to COVID-19 pandemic. Singapore Airlines is the flag carrier of Singapore and one of the subsidiaries of Singapore Airlines Group along with Scoot and Silkair. Their headquarters is also located at Singapore itself. Singapore Airlines was known as Malayan Airways Limited in the year of 1947, and it later became as Malaysia Singapore Airlines in May 1966. However, it was soon separated into two airlines, which are Malaysian Airlines System and Singapore Airlines as we know of today. The branding of Singapore Airlines focused on their flight attendants, where their uniform has a strong kebaya design and it has been a part of their marketing since 1972. The air stewardess are known as Singapore Girls, and it became a signature of Singapore Airlines over the years.
Coming to the next point, now I'm going to start with a literature review where I will give you an overview and the description of the Singapore Airlines and the impact of COVID-19 on the Singapore Airlines. So here we start with the first point. They have faced a lot, that is uncertainty and the complexity. Here we will record up according to the passengers and the less or less sell of tickets, the travel overall the world, and or suspended the overall 50% of the additional services provided by them. It is that it was a loss making year for the Singapore Airlines. COVID-19 had impacted the aviation industry and said also that they had $42 million of Singapore third quarter ended in the 31st December 2020 as compared to the year. They incurred loss of $330 million of Singapore as compared to the previous year. They had earned profit at the same time of approximately $780 million of Singapore. Next point is additional investment made. They had made the investment for their recovery through the COVID-19 impact on their industry. Assume that they had a major impact adversely on 2021 half passed by COVID-19. Said that they will raise an additional investment that is $6.2 billion of Singapore, and they had also that they had actually raised about $2 billion of Singapore for their recovery. Of Singapore Airlines in their future plans and their suggestions they had prepared for to recover through COVID-19 are that they should and they are planning to be a cost efficient for the next coming year, as the travelers have they changed their behavior of traveling in the airlines and they need all the precautions, and they have and the country had decided that Singapore industry is facing a lot of problems, and they had planned to be a cost efficient in the upcoming years. So deferred a quarantine free travel bubble by Singapore and Hong Kong. Hope for the best, and they are reconstructing to pave their way to rebound by COVID-19 pandemic.
Hi, this is Sanagayade. Now I'm going to explain methodology part. This study is based on completely secondary data analysis, and we have used several newspaper article as well as some research paper to our study. As we know that COVID-19 pandemic was started in December 2019. It had negative impact on every airline industries, and it made some huge losses to airline industries. Singapore Airlines also faced this kind of issues in the pandemic time. But now Singapore Airlines is taking precautions to their customers, and negative report is must needed to travel, and as well as complete sanitization before getting into plane. So with these precautions, Singapore Airlines is taking a great precautions to their customers with SIA cares. Now airline industry is slowly recovering, and it will become to normal stage in future days, and future parts will be explained by my friends. Thank you.
I'm going to present about discussion. The allied business is one of the most seriously affected by COVID-19 and is on the point of extinction after travel bans and limited impulse by the governments around the world. Singapore Airlines are restructuring their operation in order to recover from the COVID-19 pandemic. However, the latest quarterly results show that many continues to suffer major loss as the industry outlook dims due to current virus outbreak in the region. The first point of the discussion is performance. Singapore Airlines was an outstanding performer. It served only 596,000 passengers in the quarter ending March, a 98% decrease from the previous year due to the global travel limited impulse to control the spread of COVID-19. Vaccination speed in Asia has been slower than in the US and Europe. The airline's outlook remains uncertain, especially India, Malaysia, Thailand, Japan, and more. In normal times, Singapore Airlines flies to 13 cities in India, including Mumbai and Chennai. Second point of the discussion is maintaining a strong balance sheet. Rumor opinion columnist David Finkley argued that even an airline with an extremely strong balance sheet will be unable to survive the flow out of the COVID-19 crisis without the support of finance supported such as governments or largest shareholders. The point of the discussion is lack of awareness. Furthermore, many latest COVID cases in Singapore has been related to a group that emerged at Changi Airport, resulting in temporary shutdown of passenger terminals. The last point of the discussion is lower dependence on premium travelers. Most premium airlines get a significant amount of their revenue and profit from premium passengers. Strategies such as fleet renewal and new customer convenience are mainly aimed at gaining the loyalties of these passengers.
Hello everyone, I am Anshul Santosh Rai, studying at Vivekananda Education Society of Art, Science and Commerce, and I am a team member of Team 39. I feel highly privileged to be part of Assam Anusandhan Project 2020 and 21. So I am here to present some findings and suggestions for Singapore Airlines. So if we talk about an exemplary performance, so considering SIA's exemplary financial performance, it has been continued to be in a profit till this year, but now it is reduced up to 96%. Next, if we talk about maintaining a strong balance sheet, undoubtedly balance sheet are a robust and a prudent strategy for an airline which could face a many hard situations. As SIA is one of the premium airline, it chooses to splurge on unnecessarily plans on renewable fleet. So further we move on a lower renewal of the fleet. Though the average age of a SIA's fleet is approximately 5.5 years about a decade ago to 7.5 years today, SIA is one of the leading airlines to operate youngest fleet. Debt financially generates additional expenses in downturn. The fixed cost can be like to a million ton around odd airline's neck. Thank you.
In conclusion, the problems faced by Singapore Airlines during the COVID-19 pandemic were expenses and renewal of fleet. Singapore Airlines should have contingency plans in the events where adverse events were to occur, such as pandemic or a natural disaster. They will also need to comply to the rules and regulations set by the government to ensure smooth operation and reduce the risk of spreading the COVID-19 virus. Lastly, they need to ensure that employees are practicing social distancing, wear face masks, and have good hygiene at all times. Same goes for the passengers as well. They should ensure the passengers are healthy and fit to travel during the pandemic to prevent them from infecting the virus. Thank you.